Hello, Saggies. I missed you guys. I hope you're doing wonderful wherever you are. I hope you had a beautiful, relaxing weekend. Saggies, you want a soulmate reading to check up on the latest energies between you and your soulmate. First, as usual, we're going to ask what's coming up for you, what you'll be dealing with, facing in your life, and how you're currently doing on your soulmate journey. Second part of this video, we're going to ask about your soulmate. Whoever it is you're thinking of concentrating on while watching this video, whether you're currently in contact with them or not, first we're going to ask how this person is doing at this time and how they are currently relating to you emotionally. What's on their mind? What are they thinking, feeling at this time? Especially in relation to you, Saggies. Universe, please step into a very clear and important messages for the sign of Sagittarius. For Sagittarius, highest good, please. Universe, please show us what's coming up for Saggies in their life and how is Sagittarius currently doing on their soulmate journey. What's coming up for Saggies in their life and how is Sagittarius currently doing on their soulmate journey? Let's see, Saggies. This strongly wants to show up as extra message for you. Oh boy, your soulmate is taking over this reading for some reason. So this person is showing up, your soulmate is showing up as someone who is very much set in their ways. They don't like to express emotions. They don't like to show emotional vulnerability. They don't like to initiate communication. This person wants to communicate with you so badly. They've been waiting patiently to see if you're going to reach out to them, but they know they're going to have to be reaching out to you. This is them waiting to communicate with you at the right time. A lot of you are dealing with Sagittarius and Aries. It looks like this person likes to be alpha in relationships. They like to be in control. They like to be admired. They like to be recognized for their accomplishments in life. They may very well be attractive and successful at what they do, but they don't express emotions easily. They don't communicate with you effectively. Now, there are serious communication issues. Wow, your energy is beautiful. Beautiful. Empress energy. They respect you so much. They view you for who you truly are. Someone who is a catch in relationships. Someone who is of high quality standards. Yeah. Yeah. They worry that you're not going to reconcile with them. They're very worried because the judgment is reversed. This person is very worried that it's over, that you made up your mind already, that you're not going to give them another chance. They're so worried that you're going to view them as weak, as needing you. This person has a lot of pride. Yeah, they pay too much attention to sexual energy, not enough to feelings, emotions, and communication when they are in relationships. Universe, please, yeah, very passionate, but they don't express emotions. There's no balance between passion and feelings. It's like it's all about passion, sexual energy. Universe, please show us what's coming up for Saggies and how is Sagittarius currently doing on their soulmate journey. Some of you are dealing with Taurus. They feel it's the end, that you let them go already. This person knows they can only come back to you with significant changes in their behavior. Yeah. They know they can't just come back to you with more of the same behavior and ask for different results. Yeah. See, this person has very hard time initiating communication with you. They're protecting their heart just in case you reject them. What concerns me here is that I don't see any cup cards, any emotions, feelings. Just a lot of passion. I don't see any emotions yet. New person is entering your life. Person of quality. someone who can offer a solid relationship. I love King of Wands energy. So it looks like you already know the new person, whether you're aware of their interest in you yet or not. Someone of quality is very interested in you, views you for who you truly are. Yeah, I love King of Wands energy, one of my favorite kings. So King of Wands is someone who's very mature because they are a king. Someone who is a go-getter, successful. This person here wants to communicate with you. So they took over your reading. My goodness. They want to see you. They want to communicate with you. This means making amends, but they don't want you to know that they are desperate to reconcile with you, which they are. They really want to so badly reconcile with you, but they don't want you to know that. Oh, my goodness, they have so much pride. It's hard for them to apologize, to make amends. Yeah. They in love. Finally, we see Cups card. King of Cups with two cups. So this person is in love with you, but they hide it really well. They don't express it. They don't show it. And because they're holding two cups, not one, they're trying to figure out what it is you feel for them at this time. Whether you miss them, love them, they don't know. They're checking up on you heavily to see who is in your life, what you're doing, what you're up to. This person also is comparing you to other people from their past. They realize you're so different from other people that they've been with. They took you for granted. Yeah. You are so different. You stand out in a crowd of many. You are of high value and quality. This person doesn't want to see you with somebody else. They are concerned that you're going to be with somebody else in a relationship. They're checking up on you. So betrayal is showing up here. You feel betrayed by this person. Yeah, whether they withheld some kind of important information from you or deceived you or hit somebody else. Whatever it was serious, and they feel it wasn't worth losing you over. The Sun, the best card in the whole deck. This person finally sees how good they had it. They finally recognize your quality. They finally waking up and realizing that they can't let you go because they love you deeply, you see, but that love is unexpressed. They took over your reading. Universe, please show us what's coming up for Sagittarius. How is Sagittarius currently doing? You're concentrating on your job, finances, business, money. You have some shady people at your job. We all have them, right? But some snakes are showing up here. You have to be careful who you trust at your job. Remember, your coworkers are not your friends. Don't ever mix business with pleasure. Your friends are not your coworkers, and your coworkers are not your friends. Okay, so don't mix those two together. A lot of people make that mistake, and it blows up in their face eventually. So yeah, remember, your coworkers, your business partners, your bosses are not your friends, no matter how friendly they may seem. Keep it all business. You have some fake people at your job. They're showing up here as two snakes. The soulmate wants to come towards you with some kind of emotional offer, but they're showing up as not being in your life in a beneficial way because the devil is showing up here. So something serious is going on with this relationship. You recognize it clearly that this became a toxic connection that drained you, and you need to let it go, at least for time being. You have at least two people at your job that wish to see you fail. You're not gonna fail, okay? When people are jealous, that means you're doing something right. Continue doing what you've been doing. Continue being proactive, passionate. Don't let negative people affect you. Just watch your back. Yeah, just be careful. Ugh. Wow, the devil energy. Let me see what's going on with that soulmate. The universe, please show us. What's going on currently with that soulmate of Sagis? That Sagis are letting go of, that showed up as King of Cups and Emperor. What's going on currently with that soulmate of Sagis? That Sagis are letting go of, at least for now. And how's that soulmate of Sagis towards Sagis at this time, especially emotionally? They didn't put work into this and they realize they lost you or are losing you. They realize they didn't put work into this. This person is used to people who are not like you. They're not used to people in the life of your high quality. They didn't know how to treat you correctly. They're in love with you. So for the second time, they're showing up as King of Cups. This time from Bigger Tarot Deck. This person's in love with you. They're quiet, silent. They realize that what they feel for you is deep, real, genuine love, not some kind of crush that's going to fade away. They're trying to process all these feelings. They realize they can't just turn them off. I don't think this person realized how much you meant to them emotionally until they lost you or feel like they're losing you. They're trying to make sense of what's going on, what they're feeling, trying to figure out how to approach you correctly if it's not too late. A lot of you are dealing with Virgo, Leo, Libra, Scorpio, and Aquarius popping up here, and Capis. Universe, please show us. It could be really any sign, yeah. But those are the signs that are popping up here strongly. Universe, please show us. This person doesn't know how to put work into relationships. They're so concerned about the work image at the job, success at the job. They feel unbalanced between their business life and their personal life. Universe, please show us what's going on currently with that soulmate of Sagis. And how's that soulmate of Sagis towards Sagis at this time, especially emotionally? For the third time, they're showing up as King of Cups from two different tarot decks. So this person is in love with you. They realize they can't let you go. Ooh, you told them off. You told them what time it is. You cut them out of your life. So you were very honest, blunt, direct. You didn't sugarcoat. They view us very guarded towards them emotionally, not trusting them. Yeah. Yes, you confronted them already. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this person's checking up on you to see what's going on. If you're cooling off, if you're going to reach out to them, they're trying to wait patiently to see if you're going to cool off, reach out to them. They know if you don't, they're going to have to approach you, but they're so scared of your rejection. Yeah, they're so petrified of your judgment, rejection, saying no to them. They want to manifest you back in their life. They're very determined to communicate with you, to see you. Oh my goodness. This person has a lot going on in their life that they need to resolve, figure out. Yeah, a lot stuff going on in their life that has nothing to do with you, that needs to be addressed. They like recognition for their accomplishments in life. They love to be admired. Yeah. The ego is in the way of this relationship, though. Universe, please show us what's going on currently with that soulmate of Sagis. For the fourth time, my gosh, this person's in love with you. They're not able to let you go emotionally, release you. They're not able to. Yeah, it's like they're hiding it. They're not telling you or not showing you or both how much you mean to them emotionally. They don't like to feel this deep emotional vulnerability. It scares them to feel such deep, intense emotions like they feel for you that they can't control. This person likes to be in charge, in control. They like to be alpha, and they realize they can't control their feelings. They can't just turn them off when they feel like it. They spying on you, checking up on you, showing up here as a fox, checking up to see what you up to, what you're doing, who is in your life. They want to break this silence. This person would prefer you reach out to them first, but honestly, they need to be reaching out to you, extending, yeah, extending the olive branch to you. It looks like they're planning to communicate with you because they're realizing that no matter how long they wait, you are pretty much done with this situation. Sagittarius, we're going to go into your extended reading. Obviously, we're going to ask about this person, but also new soulmate entering your life that showed up as King of Wands, one of my favorite kings. So first, however, we're going to ask about this soulmate's true, genuine, long-term intentions and plans for you. What they're planning long-term. Then we're going to ask what they're currently hiding from you, whether they're hiding it on purpose or can't communicate for whatever reason. But the universe feels you need to be aware of for your highest good. And of course, at the end, we're going to ask advice for you on how to best handle this soulmate connection at this time. And anything else you need to know about your life, including new soulmate entering your life, the King of Wands energy, new chapters, new beginnings in your life, also your health, finances, business, job opportunities, family matters, friendships, whatever it is you need to know, they'll show it at the end of the reading as well. So Sagis, click on the extended link below this video in the description box below, and I'll see you there. Love you guys.